Welcome to Career Insights. The Career Insights series features local industry professionals engaged in conversation with students and recent graduates about career planning and job opportunities in Polk County, Florida.
Welcome, everybody. My name is Laura Webster. I am a District Academy Coach with Polk County Public Schools Workforce Education and Career Academies. Mr. Jackson, are you there?
Yes, I'm here. My name is Mr. Jackson. I work with the Business Marketing, IT, and Tech Ed programs for the district and supporting all of those teachers. So happy to meet you all.
That is perfect. It's Mr. Johnson.
I am so excited to be here. And I really want to talk about digital media and what we have to offer. So good morning, everyone, and welcome. Digital media is an amazing and awesome program. And one of the things we pride ourselves in is that what we provide you is that great hands-on experience so that when you come here at Polk State and you partake in the digital media program, and when you graduate, you can go out and you can immediately get a job and you can start being productive on day one. We offer three kind of major areas, and I want to focus on those. So at the Polk State College, you can get a bachelor's degree, an associate degree, and of course also certificate programs. Well, for digital media, we offer an associate degree track where you can do your general education degrees, but you can also focus on the digital media areas, and you can focus on the courses that basically all the state universities will accept. So when you do these courses here at Polk State, you can go to UCF or USF or, you know, any of the state universities here in Florida, or just about any place else, and your courses that you do in digital media will easily transfer to that university. And if you're not interested in transferring to, say, UCF or USF or wherever, then you can do an AS degree, and that's the AS track right here. And we offer two of those. And those AS tracks, those are offered in graphic design and video production. And those are two really hot and upcoming areas that just about everybody is interested in and really wants to know about. If you have some kind of degree before, or you're just thinking, I don't know, want to kind of tip my toes in there a little bit and learn a little bit more about digital media, then you can do certificate programs. It's really designed for people who already have degrees and want to add to their skill set. But if you're kind of thinking about it, I'm not really sure, then it's something that you can do. It takes really 1 year, two semesters, and you can complete the certificate program. But better yet, when you complete that certificate program, all the courses you do transfer back into the AS tracks. So you're not losing anything, or you're not even taking a risk, because all the courses can be reused for your AS degree if you decide, man, I like this stuff and I want to continue and I really want to do it. Now, getting it done is really easy. Courses are rated about 3 credits, and that may not make a lot of sense to a lot of folks, but just think about it this way. For about 20 courses, you can complete your associate degree, whether it be the Associate of Arts degree or the Associate of Science degree. It's about 20 courses. Some are a little bit extra, a little bit more you have to take, but that's about it. So you're looking at about 2 years to complete your AA or AS degree, and 1 year to complete your certificate program. So let's talk about kind of the AA track just a little bit here. So generally, the way that's divided up is that you get 36 credits, general credits. So these are your humanities, your math, your English, your comp, those kind of things. And then you get to take 24 elective credits. And that's where the digital media and art courses and all the wonderful things that you get to do, that's where all that comes into play. The AS track, as I mentioned before, is for job skills. And so we're talking about, you know, graphic design, video production. Those are the two areas that we offer in digital media. And that's about the time that it takes to complete those that AS degree, 2 years. And that includes about 6 courses in general education track and about 14 courses in digital media credits. And I want to just point out here just a little bit about what that means. So let me give you some examples. I'm going to type in Studio 1308, which is a really quick way of getting to our website. And the first link here I want to click on. So I want to show you just kind of what we do here in digital media. We produce a weekly program. It's called DM Reports. And this is a video that's sent out to all the college. It's placed on the college's main website. So if I go to polk.edu here, for instance, you'll see that this is listed on there right there. So there it is. Anyway, we produce this weekly program, and our staff does an amazing job, and we can include students in there. So if you're looking for hands-on, practical examples of what we do. Look at this page. You can scroll through and you see all of these videos that talk about, you know, Women's History Month or tutorials or student spotlights or just whatever. And these are actual videos that include lots of graphics and animation and text and typography and color and all these amazing things. I can click on it here and it shows you the animation introductory sequence. And then it shows you kind of what we do. It gives you just virtual house sessions. It has an animation that we can use here about Earth Day. We can talk about all these wonderful things. Anyway, what this does, it gives you weekly hands-on activities that you can use so you can build up your skills and make an amazing difference. As far as our certificate programs are concerned, you can go over here on our left and you can simply click on that. And our website contains all this information about the certificate programs, about the course sequence, about what's involved, about what you can do. If you want to know what the courses are all about, you can click on our course descriptions over here on the left and you can say, hey, what is that DIG 2000? What's it all about? You can click on it. It pops down. You can see all the information here about what the course is like and about what you can do. And this applies to everything. So you can see right here, in our program core, you've got these core 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 courses that are required for the core. And then you can specialize in our video production track or in our graphic design track. And you get 6 additional courses. Again, simply clicking on each one gives you the information about the course that you can do and you can use. So it's all there for you. What are the prerequisites for courses? Click here on prerequisites and right there tells you what the prerequisites are. What about the course sequences? When do you take courses? Well, for the video track, you can see it here. Fall semester, all of these right here. Spring semester, right here. Summer one, all here. It tells you clearly for graphic design, same thing. It's all there so you can have it right there at your fingertips. How do you plan for your courses? Well, we tell you when the courses are offered here in the fall and spring semesters, in the fall semesters, in the spring semesters. So you can know, and you can plan ahead as to when you can take different courses. Not only that, we showcase our students' work. So here, we talk about the best of digital media. You can click on there. You can see work that our students have done, Mr. Interview or Hollow Dream, just whatever it is, it's all showcased there. Every single semester, we have a student showcase. It's phenomenal. And we showcase hundreds of our students' work. The last one we did was in 2019 because of, you know, the pandemic, you know, all that stuff. We couldn't do it for 2020. But we're going to resume it as soon as everybody is vaccinated. But you can go here. But what's beautiful, you can click on each of these categories and you can see the submissions for each of this work and you can browse through and watch the video and see who won and what they submitted. But I want to talk about something that's even more important, but our departmental staff. So we have, of course, you know, that crazy guy there, that's the one talking really, really fast. We have Professor Joyce here and he also teaches graphic design and digital media. This is Ashley Bramble and she's our program specialist. And then I call this my secret weapon. These are our teaching lab assistants and here they are and they are absolutely phenomenal. Let me tell you what they do. They make sure that you are successful in digital media. So for instance, if you go into the classroom and you're like, man, that Johnson guy, he talks so fast. I can't understand a word that he says. You go into the lab and guess what? They speak Johnson. They understand the assignments. They've done all the work. They've taken the classes before and they can help you get the job done. So if you're frustrated, go into the lab and you are going to be amazed. These are people who are eager and waiting, ready to help you. You don't know what the inspiration you need to do a design. They can help you with that. You don't know how to use a tool in Adobe Photoshop. They can help you with that. You don't know how to do a vector art in Adobe Illustrator. They can fix your write-up. You don't know how to do a video in Adobe Premiere Pro. They can fix your write-up. I'm telling you, folks, whatever your concern in digital media, our lab staff are the people ready and waiting to help you be successful. That's your tagline. We are here to help you succeed. When I go to a digital media lab, we have a whole space, a lab space set up, designed just for you with massive servers. You can go to any computer. You have access to all your files anywhere in the department, and it's there waiting for you. Our lab staff will help you design whatever you want. Here we have one and Camry helping some students in their design class. The lab is open Monday through Friday from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m., 4 p.m. on Fridays we close, and they can help you with whatever you need. So here, let me zoom in just a little bit. You see Adobe Premiere and Audition, all of this stuff, we can help you. You can also borrow equipment. So you don't have a laptop, we can lend you a laptop. You don't have a camera, we can lend you a camera. You don't have space on a website, we can get you space on a website. Whatever it is you need, we can help you with that and much more. You can borrow it, take it home, use it, bring bring it back. And that way you have all the assets and the resources you need. You need the wonderful photograph that you can't find anyplace else. We have a subscription to Adobe Stock. You can get that photograph. You want some audio, some sound effects. We have subscriptions. We can get you there. The cost to come to Polk State compared to, I don't know, UCF or a private institution. I mean, they're private colleges that are charging like $50,000 a year. $50,000. You know what I could do with $50,000? And they're charging you all of this money to get a, you know, per year to get a degree. You can come to Polk State. Tuition is like $120-something per credit hour. So you can take a class for like $350 or something like that. One class, and you boom, you got a class done. Other places are charging you $600, $800, $1,800 for a class. Polk State, get it done for like under $350 per class. So you could have your amazing education. We could come to Polk State for 2 years, get your associate's degree, and you can do so for just a minimal, you know, $5,000 a semester kind of thing, and complete your degree program, your two-year degree program at Polk State, and then transfer to a state university. It'll cost you a little extra, but at least, you know, you have saved half the cost by coming to Polk State. And that's what's wonderful and beautiful about what we offer. And we offer an amazing education. I mean, small class sizes, professors who are concerned about you, who care about you, who want you to succeed. And it's offered right here in Polk County, Polk State, whether it be digital media or art or technology or computing or just whatever it is. All these departments are sitting here ready and waiting, wanting to offer you what's best. Last quick thing, my time is just about up here. So you can, if jobs or career is a big concern for students, they're always thinking, hey, will I get a job when I'm done? You know, can I find jobs? Well, guess what? We made that easy for you. You go on our website, you click on jobs and careers right there, and you can see the kind of jobs you can get as a video production artist. But you can click on these links right here, and these are live links. So if I click on monster.com, for instance, it will link to actual jobs available right here, right now, live and ready in that particular area. And you can scroll through and see and apply for these jobs. So you don't have to guess. Oh, 14 days ago, 26, 60 days ago, you can see the jobs offered there because these are live links. You can go to Orlando Jobs and click under video production. You can see the kind of video production jobs available. So you don't have to wonder, will I get a job? You can see the jobs available from our website that are available right here, right now. And it's amazing. So give us a call, contact our staff, come to our lab, talk to me, send me an email, whatever it is you need. And we're right here ready to help you be successful at Polk State.
Sorry, I was busy applying for your program. Hang on. That was great. That was very exciting. So thank you so much for that. That was great. We appreciate your enthusiasm and your passion for your program. We are right on track to talk a little bit about supply chain with Monica.
Hi, everyone.
There you are.
Wow, what an act I have to follow. It's really much easier to talk about supply chain these days because of COVID. People recognize the importance of being able to deliver a product from Mother Earth to the end consumer. And that's what we do in supply chain. So the AS degree here at Polk State gives you all of the necessary foundations to start your job, start your career in supply chain. You would also be able to tailor your track and go towards a bachelor's degree should you like to at another university. So supply chain AS degrees, entry level, if you have no experience, is somewhere in the $36,000 to $40,000 range. It's not too bad. But the average degree, the average associate's degree makes around $62,000 a year. Not so bad. And when you start looking at getting more education and more experience and more certifications, you know, it's not uncommon to be making in the $100,000 to $200,000 range. So let's talk about what the program has. It has general education requirements and then very focused program requirements, which include accounting, an introduction, warehouse management, transportation and logistics, quality management. So all of the inner workings of both a service or manufacturing company or a distribution center. The other wonderful thing is not only do you get the exposure to all of these classes, you are being taught by adjuncts and faculty that have a wealth of experience. They'll also, as you go through this AS degree, have the opportunity to earn a logistics and transportation specialist certificate, which is an accreditation that is provided through the Council of Supply Chain Management Professionals, or CSCMP, and can lead you towards a much higher certification called the SC Pro. I'd like to introduce Kyle Davis. Kyle is a director of warehousing for Publix.
Good morning, everyone. Again, as Monica stated, my name is Kyle Davis. I am director of warehousing at Publix, working on my 33rd year at Publix. So I'm going to go down the list based on the previous slides. As it pertains to accounting, I've had a similar journey of many of you that have been on the line today. But based on the accounting, our teams have a capital planning budget that we have annually of in excess of $800 million. So accounting experience, understanding the different types of accounting, understanding forensic accounting as well, is very important to us in what we do. As it pertains to supply chain, at Publix, obviously, we source product from all over the world. At all five of our refrigerated distribution centers at Publix, we receive produce on a daily basis. We have to be consciously aware of regulations, guidelines, and requirements as it pertains to quality. It's the only way that we can provide the customer with quality produce on a daily basis is one example. One other example that's hot and talked about quite a lot as it pertains to supply chain is the COVID vaccine. And it just so happens that my team, the Pharmacy Warehouse located in Orlando, handles the vaccine and the distribution of the vaccine to all the public stores. So on a daily basis, it's been a high priority of mine as well as the team that we have in Orlando to make sure that we're accurate, we're timely, we understand regulations, temperature requirements, and all those things. But it takes a well-coordinated team because on a daily basis, we're receiving vaccine, turn it around and push it back out to the respective stores on a daily basis. As it pertains to leadership and transportation, I tie them together because my leadership skills help to add value to transportation. Believe it or not, right now we're preparing for hurricane season. Water is being produced. We're receiving it. I'm storing it in strategic locations. And as it pertains to commercial law and legal, I review numerous documents on a daily basis. I got up early this morning before I flew up to Jacksonville today to be able to understand what's going on with our regulatory agencies, as well as within the community, the government and the federal government. I would also add that negotiations is part of my life as it pertains to procurement of different things, working with the various counties, state, and federal agencies. And then lastly, in terms of the intro to business, we refer to it as operational excellence. Operational excellence is very important to us because we know that our customers do not want to pay more than what's expected on the shelf. So to do that, we have to make sure that in distribution, in which we have over 9,000 associates, we're doing our part to keep the cost down, understanding business requirements, how to achieve successful teams, keeping them organized and helping them understand who the customer is. Lastly is the project, the Greensboro Project, which I've been given to sponsor. Again, it's the largest actual project that we've had at Publix Supermarkets. It's in excess of $500 million. It's more than 1 million square feet. I'm typically in Greensboro every couple of weeks. We're on weekly conference calls. This facility will be designed to relieve the Atlanta Distribution Center and requires a lot of coordination with accounting, with transportation, legal team, many negotiations with the municipalities and government to be able to pull this project together. This facility is scheduled to open next fall and will start out with over 1,000 positions of Publix associates that we're going to be hiring. Half of them will be from the community there. That's all I have, Monica.
Great. Thanks, Kyle. So as you can see, this is just one of our adjuncts, one of our best adjuncts that we have. We have many more to check out, and you've gotten great insight into how to get to the Polk EDU website and just check out the supply chain management. We have the similar links to what you saw from Dr. Johnson, and we encourage you to contact us at supplychain@polk.edu, and we'll get back with you with whatever information you need. Thanks for your time.
Thank you.
Thank you to our panelists for presenting this very valuable information today. And thank you to our schools, teachers, administrators, and students for attending. And hope everybody has a great week. Thank you.